Hey everyone, so today we are going to look at an example or we are going to see a linear map which has no real eigenvalues. Okay, so I am taking a T from one vector space to the same vector space. What is my vector space? It is set of all continuous functions over real numbers. We know that this forms a vector space, and I am defining a map T which will take a function as an input. F is a function, and what is the output? Output is T of F. Okay, or I will say this is the good way to write. Tf is the output in V. Now this is also a function, and how I'm defining this function, Tf f of x is nothing but you simply integrate from 0 to x. So this x goes to x over here, and you integrate the function. So you take a function and you simply integrate from 0 to x. Does it exist? Yes, because f is continuous. So by Riemann theory, we know that integration of continuous function do exist. So this is what the function we are defining. And this particular example, I have seen in the book of Hoffman and Kunz. And so I thought of sharing with you all. So we'll show that this has no eigenvalues. Okay, so let's go step by step. First, I will prove that lambda equal to 0 can't be the eigenvalue. So I'll be playing with two cases. Case 1. Suppose your lambda is 0. That means what? Your Tf is equal to 0f by definition of eigenvalue and eigenvector, where f is an eigenvector. Eigenvectors are always non-zero. So this is a non-zero function f, and 0 is the eigenvalue. So suppose if lambda equal to 0 is an eigenvalue, then we have this equation. That means what? What is Tf? Tf of x, it is nothing but integration 0 to x f of t dt. And what is my right hand side? It is 0, because 0 into anything is 0. Okay, now what can you say about the function over here? Now, by fundamental theorem of calculus 1, okay, what does a fundamental theorem of calculus says? If I take the derivative over here, derivative of 0 is 0. What is derivative of integration? It is nothing but the integrand. If you don't know what is FTC1, then my suggestion is you please see that lecture. Link you can find in the description. Okay, so derivative of integration is integrand, and this is my 0 only. So what I'm getting is my function is identically 0. Okay, I'm getting f to be 0. But is this possible? No. Why? Because my f is an eigenvector, and eigenvectors are always non-zero. Okay, so therefore lambda equal to 0 case is not possible. Therefore, for this transformation, 0 can never be an eigenvalue. Okay, now let's go for my case 2. Our case 2 is, suppose your lambda is a non-zero real number. It's a non-zero real number. If lambda is non-zero, can it be an eigenvalue? Answer is no. Why? Let's see. Suppose lambda is an eigenvalue. Okay, suppose lambda is an eigenvalue and non-zero, that means what? That implies your Tf is equal to lambda f, where f is an eigenvector, non-zero. Okay, so this implies what? Integration 0 to x f of t dt is equal to lambda times f of x. Fine. Okay, now here one thing you need to observe. What is f of 0? What is f of 0? So from here one can observe, when I replace my x by 0, so what will I get? When I replace x by 0, 0 to 0 f of t dt is equal to lambda times f of 0. But when the upper and the lower limits are same, that means this integration is 0. So 0 is equal to lambda into f of 0. But my lambda is non-zero, therefore f of 0 has to be 0. Okay, so if we have a non-zero eigenvalue lambda, then that function should pass through origin. So that's the first observation. Okay, that's one thing we have. Okay, good. Now what can you say about the function? Now again, you apply fundamental theorem of calculus. You differentiate both sides with respect to x. So derivative of this integration 0 to x f of t dt is equal to lambda into derivative of f. Now usually people say ki f is not given to be differentiable, it is given to be continuous. But here if you see, we have this equality. What does FTC says, fundamental theorem of calculus? If you have a continuous function, then you can integrate. Then this function is differentiable and continuous. So since my right hand side is differentiable, sorry, my left hand side is differentiable and it is equal to this thing. Therefore, this is also differentiable. Okay, so under such scenarios, if lambda is an eigenvalue and f is an eigenvector, non-zero, then this side is differentiable and therefore this makes sense. Okay, now again by FTC, derivative of integration is integrand. So I have f of x equal to lambda into f dash of x. Now if I do variable separable, 1 upon lambda equal to f dash of x upon f of x. Here is the second time I am using that lambda is non-zero. Earlier we used lambda is non-zero for this condition, and now I can divide by lambda because it is non-zero. And now if I integrate both sides, what will I get? This implies x upon lambda is equal to log of mod of f of x plus c. Okay, so I can write plus c over here, doesn't matter. And what is my f of x then? E raised to x by lambda plus c, and then e raised to c I am calling some another constant d. Okay, so this is what I have. But what is f of 0? F of 0 is given to be 0. So when I replace x by 0 over here, where should I write? Okay, let me write here. So if this is 0 is equal to f of 0 is equal to d into e raised to 0, which is 1. So this implies your d is 0. And this implies your f is identically 0, which is a contradiction because our f is an eigenvector. So it has to be non-zero. So if lambda is non-zero real number, which is an eigenvalue, therefore for that eigenvalue we will have an eigenvector. And then using FTC, fundamental theorem of calculus, and using the fact that lambda is non-zero and f of 0 is 0, we get that our function has to be a multiple of exponential function. But then again from here we get that function has to be a zero function. It does not have any other choice. And then which contradicts to the fact that f is an eigenvector. Therefore, for this integral operator, it does not have any eigenvalue. So I hope this is clear. If yes, then do not forget to like, share and subscribe. Thank you.